For thousands of years, humans have been the dominant life form on Earth. What we lack in speed, strength, tooth or fang, we make up in intelligence. We have created tools to support us. And while they have been faster or stronger, they have never been smarter or more creative than us. However, this may be about to change. These remarkable achievements are not linear. Deep Blue was programmed how to play chess, but it could only play chess. If you gave it a different game, it had no understanding. The more recent achievements are entirely different, because these programs were not designed for a single task, but rather designed to learn. IBM's Watson doesn't just play Jeopardy, but has also learned how to create unique recipes and how to diagnose sickness. This learning process is known as machine learning. Machine learning is a process of giving computers the ability to learn without being explicitly programmed. The program analyzes patterns to isolate what matters. This is similar to how we learn as humans. These programs are capable of learning from experience. Machine learning is the only way programs can succeed in complex activities, like winning at the game of Go. Go has more possible moves than atoms in the entire observable universe. It is simply not possible to program every scenario. AlphaGo won because it learned through experience. By the time AlphaGo beat the world champion, it had played 100 million games, compared to the world champion at only 50,000. Machine learning is also used by Tesla's autopilot system. Each Tesla car has always-on wireless connection. And while driving, the car collects data and feeds it back into the network to be analyzed. When the network learns how to handle a situation better, all the cars can be updated. Each day, the network absorbs thousands of hours of experience. Machine learning systems are capable of amassing lifetimes of experience in just days. These systems are going to change our world, and the rest of this video will try to answer two questions. When will your job be automated? And what does life after automation look like? The simple and unhelpful answer to when will my job be automated is, it depends. It depends on what job you have, where you are based, and your employer's desire to invest in automation. However, experts have provided specific estimates for when AI will replace humans. By 2030, AI systems will be able to meet or exceed human performance in language skills, such as reading aloud, translating foreign languages, transcribing speech, or even writing a high school essay. They will also exceed in logistics, with driverless trucks, cars, and even drones. Additionally, they will be able to perform traditional human-to-human tasks, such as a telephone banking operator and retail sales. By 2060, AI will be able to win the Pullman Math Competition, write a New York Times bestseller, and even perform surgery. At this stage, AI will be able to produce a new song in the same style as a particular performer, such as Taylor Swift, and even the most dedicated fans won't be able to tell it was made by AI. By the end of the century, AI will be able to replace humans at conducting research, and by 2150, it is predicted there will be full automation of human jobs. So it is predicted that AI will be capable of everything we do today by the year 2150. But which jobs have the highest probability of being replaced in the short term? Well, the jobs most at risk are not the stereotype blue-collar workers, but many white-collar jobs. Insurance underwriters, loan officers, credit analysts, real estate brokers, compensation and benefit managers, postal service clerks, nuclear power reactor operators, budget analysts, accountants and auditors, geological and plutonium technicians. If your job is on this list, you may want to consider retraining. All of these jobs have a high probability of automation, with a score of above 90%. To find out about your specific job, go to... You can search for your own job and understand the likelihood of automation. It's important to note that while not at the top of the list, creative style jobs are likely to also face automation. This picture was created by a program. The music you are listening to now was created by a bot. Chances are you have even read a newspaper or website article that was written by a bot. What does life after automation look like? Broadly, there are two theories. Either new jobs to replace the ones eliminated will emerge, or human participation in the workforce will reduce, either by the unemployment rate increasing or by weekly working hours reducing. I believe the most likely outcome is an increase in the unemployment rate. The current unemployment rate in the US is under 5%. In 2008, straight after the GFC, it was 11%. And during the Great Depression, it was 25%. Unemployment does not need to be that high to have a massive impact on society. And automation is predicted to eliminate 6% of jobs in the US in the next 5 years. One potential answer to high unemployment is UBI, Universal Basic Income. It is simply the idea that the government gives all citizens a regular, unconditional sum of money, independent from any other source of income. It is not a new idea, and was first mentioned over 500 years ago in Thomas More's book. Different versions of this idea have been proposed by Martin Luther King and Richard Nixon. In 2016, the Swiss voted to implement UBI, however, it was rejected. If UBI was implemented, income and work would be disconnected. This raises an interesting possibility. People could pursue their passions without any care for money. It could result in full-time backpackers, artists, and musicians, all doing what they love for the sake of it. Or perhaps, without the drive to be educated and find a job, motivation would drop and rates of depression would increase. What do you think the future looks like? Will automation result in mass unemployment? Will UBI be implemented? If UBI was implemented, how would you spend your time? Let me know your thoughts below. This has been Alex from Lifelong Learners. Give me a thumbs up, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.
Hi everybody, welcome to the outro. Alex here. I'm in Chongqing, China, the most populated city in all of China. And today, for the first time, I have my ears professionally cleaned. I hope you enjoyed the video. AI is coming, and it's going to change everything for all of us. If you want to support my channel, you can share, subscribe, leave a comment, just engage. Thanks for watching.